Hello guys, welcome back to Let's Play Dark Souls 2 Scholar of the First Sin. I'm Crudeless. How are you guys doing today? I'm awesome today, feeling really good. We left off the previous episode by defeating the pursuer up on the pedestal up there. And we got some sorceries and a lot of souls in the previous episode, so we managed to level up to level 30, starting from level 1 as a deprived naked guy. Poor Prometheus. Well, I guess we should steal the fire by going down here into the dungeons below the castle in the Forest of Fallen Giants. To get to the boss, we want to make our way over here without taking too much damage. Yeah, that's what we want to do. So in the last episode, we got some spells. As you can see, we can use Soul Arrow to kill these guys pretty easily. Spells in this game is a little bit different than it is in Dark Souls 1 and in Demon's Souls as well. Demon's Souls had a magic point system that depleted magic points you could refill, like mana, for example, in most RPG games. And Dark Souls 1 basically only had the number of cast limitations on spells, but it didn't deplete stamina. In this game, you can see our casts basically they go down once you deplete stamina when you use them. So there are a couple of things we can do. If we use a human effigy now, we'll go back to human form, as you can see. And if you notice that back there, over by the entrance, something happened. We can use life gem to get our health up, by the way. And these two little things here are summons. If you go over to this thing, you can see that this is, you can summon Pate here, who we met above. Whom we helped or got the treasure from. There's also this summon sign here, which belongs to this guy, and we can summon him as well. He fights with two shields as weapons. But I don't want to fight this guy with help, because most people, many people in Dark Souls community look down upon using summons. But there are a few fights in this game that I'm going to bring along a summon in, and those I will explain. They're tied to basically the story of the game and some events that happen later on. So that's why I'm going to use those summons. But these are not involved in those. And also, there are one more thing I wanted to mention is... What did I forget to mention? Never mind. I'll probably remember it eventually. There was one more thing, though. But in here, we'll find something important. At first point, you might think this is terrifying, but eventually you might change your mind. This guy has been tormented and trapped down here. He is the last giant, the remaining giant of the war between Drangleic and the land of the giants. And he'll do a butt stomp or a feet stomp like that, and he'll do a swipe with his hands as we saw previously. You can just go underneath his butt when he does the swipe and avoid the... When you're close to him, he'll do the butt stomp pretty much all the time. And at 50% health, he will do make some changes to the fight, making it a bit difficult, or more difficult, I would say. He's a pretty cool fight. And if you notice a little detail previously, when he gets closer to us, or at the beginning, it seemed like he noticed us. That's interesting. As you can see, he rips off his own arm to use it as a weapon. And these animations here, yeah, he's using them as a blade to fight us. He's using his own arm, ripping it off to fight us. And you can see this boss here, he's really, really made of rock-like substance, as you can see. And we saw something previously, we saw the trees here, and this guy hasn't turned into a tree, really. And now he starts jumping as well, so be careful with the range now. His range is a lot longer than it was previously. And now we are out of spells, so yeah. That might mess this up a bit. Oh well. One more hit and he should be. Yeah, there we go! The last giant is down. Well, super easy with spells. This guy is not a hard boss, to be honest. We got the Soul of the Last Giant and the Soldier Key. It's interesting that he has the Soldier Key. But as you can see, these are parts of the castle that's down here, and he was linked to this thing. So maybe these parts were carried down with him, down here in the basement. Maybe he fell down from above. And let's take a look up there. I think he may have fallen down here, because, yeah. We'll discover more about the last giant for later on, because he is one of the most important bosses for lore reasons in the entire game, actually. Which for reasons you'll see eventually. And it doesn't open this door. This is another locked door, which is... It leads into, maybe the place with the fire lizards? Yeah, it does. Yeah, we'll find out more about the last giant. Why is he here? And why did he seem to recognize us? Dun, dun, dun. And it's really interesting because he seemed to remember something. While we've spent the entire game forgetting things. And I think that's a pretty cool parallel. We have 10,000 souls, but before we go spend those souls, there are a couple of things we can do here. First of all, we can go over here and open the door, the door over here. And we'll see some cool stuff. What's the icon underneath my... Is it the Chlorinthy ring? It seems like some of my equipment is broken. But there, it went away. I guess that was a bug underneath my stamina bar. It went away now. But here there is a ring, which is a little useful. A chest with a ring inside, I guess. This is the Ring of Restoration. Before we do anything, though, let's take a look at the soul. Soul of the Last Giant. Soul of the surviving giant who was bound below the Forest of the Giants. The Lord of the Giants, who had brought wreck and ruin to the entire kingdom, was said to have been felled by an unknown warrior. Interesting. His beaten and broken remains were then dragged beneath the stronghold, where he was sealed away. So we could either use these to acquire numerous souls, or we can turn it in for some sort of weapon. Or some sort of, item. Interesting. We also got the ring. And by the way, these warning bells should like beeping and glowing now. If you watch me play the DLC of Dark Souls. This Ring of Restoration is a protective ring passed down in House Osteria. House Osteria, never heard of that. In the sacred land of Lindelt, this ring symbolized prosperity and longevity for the great House Osteria. But the ring is fragile and breaks easily, as if it hates being taken for granted. So, yeah. As you can see, it has... these other rings have about 100 durability. This one has about 70. But it regenerates health for you, so you can use it to, if you lose health, then it'll refill that. Let's just equip it now, because we don't really have another, appetizing option. Over here, we are at the place we've seen before, I think. We haven't seen the place yet, but yeah, this is a courtyard, as it seems, and there is a wooden tree here. Nothing special, except for this chest here, and the knight. With a special door behind it. Really important door for later on in the game. We are not supposed to go behind that door just yet, though. This guy, as you can see, he is some sort of royal... he has a pretty... His icon on his shield there is a big giant sun. And he looks fairly similar to the door there, and he's guarding it ferociously. We won't be able to pull him over here. Hello guys, sorry about that. I had some difficult issues there with some technical issues. The recording simply stopped, and then I was back here. I had to basically turn back my computer back on and off, but my recording was saved, so that's great. Didn't happen like in Dark Souls 1. Woo! We left off here looting this grand lance here and fighting this guy. Let's take a look at the lance first, though. A lance fashioned from rare Geist Eel, I guess. Designed for high-ranking Drangleic knights, hence the decorative design. Geist Eel equipment is is of the finest make, but Geist Eel is so rare that very few of these weapons were actually used in combat. So you can use this basically as a lance that pokes people. And up there you can see... Castle of Drangleic. And this guy, he hails from that place, so we wanna take care of this guy, and he is pretty dangerous. We wanna pull him away from this this door here. He's super defensive, but you can break his guard with a punch, for example. Let's try to punch him after he does the. You can do it like not like that, but oh well. I guess we should just take him down like this. But yeah. Oh, we got the green blossom from this guy and produce the symbol of the king, it claims. So we have to produce a symbol of a king. We'll save that for later. Because we can't go through there later on. We need to seek the king. And we also have that little icon up there. It claims something is broken, but once we go into the menu, I don't think anything is broken here. No. Well, it's probably just wrong. This chest, by the way, it's super heavy and really, really shitty, so maybe we should change it out. Well, never mind. Let's do a couple of things before we lose all of these souls. There is one more thing we want to do back here before we go. Two things before we go on. I'm only going to do one of them now, and I'll save the other one for later. So, first of all, we want to clear out these knights here. If they don't kill me, though, already. And since we're in human form, I'm just praying that we don't get invaded by other players, because that would be pretty terrible. Yeah, but let's go through this door as well with the soldier key. We haven't read the description of the soldier key. I think we can do that now if we don't get attacked. The soldier key. Key to the soldier's door in the forest of fallen giants. A fort was erected in the forest to face the giants, but now the soldiers are lost and hollowed. They are enfeebled, but not without honor, and continue to steadfastly defend their country. Really nice that these guys are so steadfast, you know? But these guys are a bit different. As you can see, he takes some more hits to kill. One more here. These guys are a little stronger as well. And they belong to somewhere else, and that's the place we're going next. Well, not next, but you're technically going there next. And up here, this is a really important place, by the way. If you go down here, you look out. Just notice these areas here for future reference, like you do in Darkroot Basin, because some events will happen here. Magic can deal pretty much large amounts of damage to these guys, so if you want to be safe, you can just use magic on these fellas. But in this playthrough, I will go a bit melee, a bit ranged with magic and stuff like that. Yeah, there we go. One shot them with the sword there. That's super nice. And drop some wood arrows. And here, if you couldn't tell already, this is the place we watched from above, or from below, I guess. And that's the huge warrior, and that's the head of the other warrior we saw below out on the sword down there. The sword. You can see it down there to the left. So yeah, we're up above the place below. We're up above the place below. And this is usually a fog door, or a wall of light in this case. And in here you'll basically always fight the pursuer. It's easier to fight him down at the platform, because this place is I guess you have less space here. But you can use the catapults here, as you see this guy is doing, to shoot at the pursuer if you want to. And this view is pretty amazing. Just check that out. Oh my god. As we're standing here with this view, I can show you one thing that's really useful with binoculars, by the way. You can use the binoculars to aim in first person and shoot these soul arrows in the different directions. So you can use this to aim at guys at range and use magic to fight them, which is super nice. And over here, we have the last of these. Well, there are a couple of these, but one of these giants here as well. And one of the hollows are attacking him, so let's take care of him first. But these are decrepid ancients, so nothing happens. But maybe something will happen later on. And the place we want to go to, you can drop down here, by the way, and there is an item down here. I think we should get that one now, to be honest, before we move on. There is a really, really good armor here. The Drangleic sword, Drangleic shield, mail, and gauntlets. Let's take a look at these. So the Drangleic sword is very popular among many strength builds. It has an A scaling, dexterity. It has A scaling dexterity. great sword of Drummond, royal army captain. An old and unadorned sword, perhaps, but the pride and joy of this venerable captain. An heirloom passed from grandfather to father, and then from father to son. Drummond and those before him used this sword to repel those who would threaten their great land. But notice that we don't get the head armor. There is no head armor for this set, but we might get that eventually. Traditional Drangleic armor belonged to Captain Drummond. Drummond's ancestors have served Drangleic for generations, principally as defenders of the great fort, but Captain Drummond is the last of this proud line. Yeah. As you can see, this armor here is super, super good. 102 to defense, as currently we have 0, so... And the weight is not too bad as well. Not too bad. Let's see what arrows does to this guy. Yeah, arrows hurt him... soul arrows do hurt him a bit, and he's basically helpless when we hit them with magic, so... Yeah, these guys won't really be posing any trouble for us as of from this point on. I don't think there's anything else back here. Almost turning into Feth from the 70th throw there, but yeah, old Rusted Clan Gauntlets there as well. Man, lucky with the drops today. Yeah, same as the previous part of the gear that we... What are you doing? What's up with these guys? Yeah, they're having a jolly good time. Must be following me, maybe. I'm not really sure. But yeah. Now we have the Drangleic armor, and we've cleared out most of this place. There's only one more area in this... technically two more areas because of the fireplace as well. But there is one more area we can visit later on, because it's not really that important as of right now. Let's go up here, and this will be reminiscent to all of you who've played Dark Souls. A nest. Welcome to the Lost Bastille, and yes, that was the eagle that carried the pursuer that we saw previously. This is the Lost Bastille, as you can see, this place. Yeah, this is a prison. The Bastille. And we can just, let's just rest here for a second before we do anything else. This is an area we can progress through to find some interesting stuff, and we will do that. Just, yeah, gonna check... Gotta use our souls up first, though, because this area is... Ooh, well, we got the Dull Ember. Pretty interesting. We've seen those in Dark Souls. What do they do in this game? An ember that radiates a dull light. This flame seems nearly exhausted, but exhibits an eerie resilience. Perhaps this is its ordinary state. And also, we get another item here. And this... is human effigy times two, so nothing special. But there are some more stuff there, so we'll go back to the Lost Bastille eventually. But before we do, let's head back to Majula and spend our souls. We've got to level up a bit more before we move on. So we could use these souls to buy some stuff from the vendor over there. As you can see, this one, she has moved over here now.
Oh, you again? Go on. It's on the cheap for you.
And her prices have been, well, they haven't been reduced, but yeah. We could buy this Fragrant Branch of Yore for 12,000, but it's really expensive at this point of the game. And I think we have one of these Fragrant Branches, don't we? No, we don't have one yet, but we will need that to progress through that place up there. So, let's talk to the Emerald Maiden. And we can level up some more. Let's see what we can get. Ooh. Should we get some more attunement? We should get our intellect up now, buffing that int up all the way, baby. What soul level are we at now? It's 35. Getting pretty nice now since we started at level 1. But now we could do a couple of things. But the first thing we want to go to the Lost Bastille. We didn't have to go to the Forest of Ancient Giants, or Forest of Fallen Giants. We could have gone to to the different areas, Hyde's Tower of Flame, as it's called. Here we can go down to the right, but let's just keep moving. Ooh, look at that tower there. Interesting. Along this path here. And we can go inside this house here. We'll do that eventually. Before we do, we want to loot this guy to get the large Titanite shard once more. We can use that eventually to upgrade our weapons. Super nice. And this guy... Oh, let's take him on. Ah, there we go. You can see some dogs down here. New enemy. You want to push this barrel down on them. Oh, that took care of those dogs. Super easy. Super easy. Beware that some of them might survive sometimes, so you want to be careful. And out here, we'll meet a familiar face. Not too long ago, we met the pursuer. And this guy's persistent. As you can see, he's over there. Yay, pursuer. So, let's just loot this thing first, though. And he will try to stab you. And he's a bit more difficult to fight this time. If we go inside this place, he will stop following us eventually. He will despawn. If you just take a look at him. He will despawn. Trust me, he will. So let's equip this ring we got. The Covetous Silver Serpent Ring. A silver ring... There he despawned, by the way. A silver ring depicted the snake. Both the servant and a manifestation of the God of Greed. Zandro. God of Greed. Greed is traditionally viewed as a vice. But only a fool allows that to ruin a good opportunity. So this one will increase the soul yield that we gain from enemies. Really nice to have. I wanted to equip that one before we fought this guy. If you walk out here again, by the way, she should respawn. And if he doesn't, then you just go back to the bonfire, I guess. He should respawn now. Come on. Oh, well. I guess we need to go back to the bonfire then. But let's do one thing first, though. Let's clear out the rest of the area. And go back and fight him later. First, we want to take care of this guy. This is one of the grave robbers, or well, he's a keeper of this Bastille here. Looks like a mummy. Looks pretty cool though. I like his design, but they're fairly weak. They can throw some magic at you, but yeah. And in here, ooh, this big tower here, this huge tower. There's a tower part over there. Didn't really think about that, but this is the tower part, and yeah. Don't fall down here, by the way. Don't die. In here, we'll find some cool, interesting, cool character. Look at this guy. Well, it's a girl, actually.
What is it? I don't know you, and you don't know me. Things are better that way. You are an odd one. Normally, people keep a safe distance when they see this mask. But you... I'm called Lucatil. From the land of Mira to the far east, across the mountains. They say Drangleic brims with powerful souls, and so I came to claim my share. But what a strange place. Even the rumors did not prepare me. You are an odd one indeed. I've always made a point of avoiding people. While you've made a point of engaging me, I can see that you are mid-journey. If you require assistance, I come from Mira, a land of knights. My sword is always ready. Don't hesitate to call upon me. Whatever happens, I won't be missed.
True knight indeed, Lucatil. So yeah, you want to talk to her here, and she also has some other points you can talk to her through the game. And she is a pretty cool character, to be honest. I like her hat, even though the head has the face of an old man. But yeah, if you talk to her here, we can use her as a summon in a future boss fight. And we want that because it has to... We need to have her to continue... We need to summon her to continue her story, basically. We got the key there. Let's take a look at the key. We got the antiquated key. A very old key. This key is very old, but in very good condition, such that it should still function. Only what lock does this key fit? I wonder. And there is a secret behind me, though, but let's take care of this guy without falling into the hole there. I thought you could backstab this guy, but I guess I was wrong. Let's just keep hammering him. Yeah, there we go. As you can see, if you turn back here, there is a ladder to the left. So you walk up on this... Ooh, the wall there, and let's climb up the ladder and see what's up here. Oh, there is some loot. Large titanite shard. We're gonna need those for our weapon. And let's just jump down again. You can proceed across this path here, but there is no way back up. You gotta go through the house to get out of here again. And I'll show you that in a few moments. But there are poison barrels. There are explosive barrels here, so be careful with the fire weapon. You want to pull this guy if you want to be really safe. You can jump out from that window up there, or that one. I'm not really sure, but to get back here. We want to make our way over here, and we want to make sure this guy doesn't muck things up. So we want to pull him with some arrows. As you can see, magic is super useful. In Dark Souls 2, it makes things considerably easier. What we want to do now, you see the giant crack down there? Well, if you remember what we did at Cardinal Tower, we want to push this barrel. And this requires some luck and some... Yeah, some luck, I guess. We need some way to ignite that. Sometimes it blows up, sometimes it does not. So we might want to use some fire on this thing. Let's hope we don't explode. Let's kill these guys first, though. And as you can see, we can't proceed out there because the key to the door is over there, or the lever. So let's make sure our health is popped up, and let's push this thing over there. Oh, come on. Nope. I don't want to hit that thing. Oh, come on, blow up. I wish I had... What was that sound there? Oh well, we can just open this door, but we don't have a key yet, so I want this to open the door for us. Come on. Okay, since we have the fire sword, let's hit the thing. There we go. Ah, that's much better. So since we don't have the key, we have to do it this way. We got the bonfire here, and inside. Ooh. Let's rest here, by the way, just for the sake of resting. And inside we will find a guy. And he's hitting something or nothing in the air, and it's pretty furious.
Oh, why can't they all be this easy? We've got a wild one here. Shape up, I say. Whoa, that's it, yes. That's the way. Dear flame. How brightly you burn. Flame, I smell flame upon you. I'm Macduff the blacksmith. All I want is a little flame. So, hand that ember to me. Right now, you imbecile. What a marvelous ember. You've got stones, I pray. Give me stones, and I'll fortify your gear.
Now we can infuse weapons. Basically, the thing I said previously, we can infuse, for example, this staff here with either magic or Dark Knight with different stones we have. So if we take, for example, this short sword here, since we have the Fire Drake stone we got previously, you could use that to give it the fire buff. You also have these other stones which can give other properties. For example, Enchanted will turn all the damage, all magic damage into physical damage. Raw stone or mundane stone will remove, make things pretty... Well, it's... Well, how is this again? It removes a lot of damage, but it makes all hits stronger, I think. Or is that raw? Yeah, it is. And we have the raw here, which basically does remove the... it removes the stats. It makes the stats buffs really, really terrible. As you can see, we have E scaling with the weapon here. You can use a bleed stone, which will increase bleed damage, poison, and dark, lightning, and fire, which we've seen. We've seen fire these in the same way. And magic will increase magic damage, as you can see. But we won't be doing that just yet. We can also buy stuff from him. He will sell us one of these. He can buy the bastard sword, the Uchigatana, a finely sharpened blade, but it has low durability. Great axe, really, really awesome. Great axe, gigantic, weighty blade designed to inflict heavy damage. Each swing of the great axe requires the full force of the body. Mastering this weapon will require the most thorough training of both mind and body. Also, the winged spear, super awesome winged spear, super awesome spear, requires dexterity. Scythe, longbow, light crossbow, and the royal kite shield. 100% block shield there. Nothing special about the shield, which is precisely why it is so easy to use, and the likely reason for its popularity. People rarely agree over what constitutes quality, but the broad popularity of these shields proves that there are exceptions. You can also buy some arrows from this guy, like iron great arrows as well. Those are interesting, those are used by great bows. You can buy large titanite shards from him and repair powder as well. But right now, he looks pretty silly. And you see there are lots of chests in this room. And he is also sitting on a chest, and I've seen so many people that think you have to kill this guy to get the chest he's sitting at, because if we go back and rest, he won't do anything. But if you light the torch here, and light this light this little torch over there, as you can see, this is where the anvil is. So he needs some fire to see the anvil, because I guess his eyesight is pretty terrible. And here we have a player summon we can use. We can summon this guy if we want help here, and we'll be able to get some help from this traveler. But let's not. Now he will move over here. And that will make us... Oh, we can get all of these loot here, all of these chests. This is pretty nice. Craftsman's Hammer and Twinkling Titanite. Twinkling Titanite is a form of Titanite with special power. Reinforced equipment that cannot normally be reinforced by up to 5 plus. What cosmic event could have created such a powerful class of Titanite? Really, really cool. This hammer is pretty shit though. Typical hammer, but it is in fact incredibly sturdy. Some say it was the hammer used long ago by a famed blacksmith of yore. Yeah. And in these, I think we'll find more shards, basically. We get some heavy bolts for the crossbow. We don't have a crossbow yet. We'll need those bolts later, trust me. Iron arrows, yeah. Don't really need those yet, though. Let's remove the torch, by the way. Titanite shard times 5, really, really useful. And here we have large titanite shards times 2. So... Let's repair or reinforce our short sword again. And we got large titanite plus sword, large fire longsword plus 5. My god, my voice is really, really terrible today. We can also upgrade other gear here, but I won't be doing that. We could also talk to him. Let's see what he has to say to us.
Flame, dear flame, I give you my all, and you wavered and faltered. From the start of time, Flame allowed man to flourish, and even now he devises new fiery arts, but his reason makes him doubt Flame, and so we waver and falter. The power of Flame, power of the gods, in the end it is all beyond our reach, and so Flame allures us. And we attempt to harness its power. Flame, I give you my...
So yeah, he's talking about flame. The flame and how it... it corrupts us. Really, really beautiful words there, Macduff. Let's make our way back to Majula first and spend our souls for a few seconds. And we could have bought the Titanite Shard, I guess. But let's not. Let's see if we can find some more later on by ourselves a level first.
Lest.
What should we upgrade now? I think we're on an intelligence buff up here. So we gotta get that point up, baby. Gotta get those points up, baby. We also want to get our strength and agility up, actually, which might seem strange to you, but yeah. Now we can warp to Macduff's workshop or the tower part. Let's go to the tower part, because we want to take care of the pursuer once more, as we did in the last episode. We want to fight him again. Revenge of the revengening. The revenge of pursuer. The pursuer strikes again. That's the best title for a movie ever. Try not to blow up the barrel now. I think we got them all, did we? Yeah, I think we did. Dropped the soul of a nameless soldier as well. I guess we could farm those here if you want to. But now it's about time we got the pursuer down once more. Come on, angry pursuer. There we go. He's back. Back with a vengeance and a smile. So we want to pull the same old attack. And he'll do the strike there once more and the overhead. So we got to be careful. As you can see, he has a bit more health now, so we want to be careful. Let's heal up. I'm going to dodge underneath that as well. I need to do the overhead strike. Yeah, that's pretty nice. We could hit him with magic. Oh, I always get hit by that freaking attack there, though. That's really, really nasty. Let's heal up instead. I want to make sure we have all the health we need. Gry! What's happened with the camera there? That was really strange. Oh, well. Give the curse blade once more. Be careful with that. Oh, my God. And he will be pretty heavy on with the attacks in this one. Make sure you don't fall in the hole to the right there, by the way. Oh, that one is pretty dangerous, so you want to be careful with those. Ah, we got cursed, crike. That wasn't supposed to happen. As you can see, we are now in hollowed form, which is interesting. We just lost our humanity, though, so it's not really that important, but we got cursed, which was pretty bad. Be careful when he does the overhead swipe, though, because he will do like a turn. He'll turn around, and every little thing, and never know the song. Yeah, let's get behind him and cut him in the back. We're out of Estus now, which is not good at all. So let's be a little careful now. Don't want to fall outside the edge there either. So. Just keep rolling, and when that one comes along, oh, one more hit should do it. And there we go. Yeah, pursuer down. We lost all our SS flasks though, but yeah. And he drops just a twinkling titanite, but 7,000 souls that's super nice. Let's homeward bone then, I think, and we will go back to Majula to spend our points on some neat little. Little stats, ooh, little stats, statsies, and then we'll be even stronger. Pursuer, he'll come back a couple of times more, I think. They added him a lot of places in the Bastille. So in the regular Dark Souls, he's not around that much. So we get into 22. Let's get our strength up to 18. This might seem weird to you guys, but trust me, we're gonna have some fun with this character. We can only if you mess up, by the way, you can just respec, of course, with this vessel here that we found in the manor. Is this enough for a new level? Is this enough? Yeah, it is. Let's get one more point in strength. There we go. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, this episode here. We killed the boss, the last giant, and we killed the pursuer again. The revenge of the revengeance, the killing again. And we also discovered Macduff's workshop, so that's pretty nice. Hope you guys enjoyed this. I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye. Bye-bye. Yeah.